Welcome back into the Sports Source. This segment brought to you by Safety Systems. Home entertainment, home automation, security systems, life safety systems. Whatever your need, VFL J.J. Sarlis and the team at Safety Systems can deliver it for you. Visit safetysystems.com to learn more about this stellar, locally owned company that I have used for years. Great people. Safety Systems. Okay, three quick questions, and we're going to make it quick. One for each of you. Josh, did the Music City Bowl loss change the way you view Josh Heupel's first season at Tennessee? And let me twist that. If you had given him a grade, and you probably did on our show at some point, I don't remember. I should. I wrote it down at home, but I've forgotten what your grade was. It was very important to me at the time.
I don't know if I remember my grade. Yeah. It was a B.
But if you gave him a grade, yeah. Does this drop the grade at all?
No, not at all. I also wouldn't have raised it with the win. If you had gotten 8 wins, that would have been great, something to celebrate. But I don't think it changes what the season was. The season was fun. It was entertaining. Offense clearly improved. Quarterback play improved. And fans are happy. And I think that's, with the season, I think that's the case, win or loss against Purdue.
Including all the things that they overcame to get there. Mm-hmm. Okay. Jimmy, I'm giving you a writing assignment. If the East is a race to catch Georgia, so we know Georgia's up in the front of this race, and Vanderbilt's down here. I don't expect another James Franklin run. So let's take George and Vandy out. The remaining five SEC East programs, if I made you look at the next 4 years in your crystal ball, you're projecting over the next 4 years kind of the average of where these teams are going to be. Forecast this East for me, if you would. Who's behind Georgia and who's on down the line?
I'll put a C note on it. I think it's Georgia. You mentioned Georgia.
You mentioned Georgia in there. Okay.
All right, so Vanderbilt is last. Yeah. So now I think it's still going to be Florida. Florida still has a lot of talent. I think Billy Napier's a good football coach. I got Tennessee third on that list. And one reason I got them ahead of Kentucky is that if you go back to 1984, how many times has Kentucky beaten Tennessee? Have they had a better overall record from time to time? Yes, they have. But they've only beat them 3 times. So I'm going to go with Tennessee ahead of Kentucky, then South Carolina, Missouri, and then Vanderbilt. All
right, very good. We got viewers in Whitley County, Kentucky, and Bell County, Kentucky, who watch our show and watch us put down Kentucky and chortle at us as they win their bowl games and get 10 wins a year. So enjoy, guys. And then, Chuck, I've got a graphic to help your decision here. Let's go ahead and put the graphic up. All right, who did the best job this year? Now that the bowls are over, these are six guys who all were picked to finish lower than they did. Mark Stoops was picked to finish third in the East. He finished second, went 10-3, and beat Iowa in his bowl game. Josh Heupel, picked for fifth in the East, finished third. 7-6 overall, lost to Purdue. Shane Beamer, picked sixth in the East, finished fourth, 7-6, beat North Carolina in their bowl game. Lane Kiffin, picked fourth in the West, finished second, finished 10-3 after they lost to Baylor last night without Matt Corral. Sam Pittman, picked sixth in the West, finished third, 9-4, beat Penn State. And then Mike Leach, picked seventh in the West, finished third, 7-6 overall, hammered by Texas Tech. Give me the 1, 2, 3 best jobs in the league, and we're not counting the Kirby Smarts, of these guys who did more with less, rank them 1, 2, 3, who did the best job this year.
Well, I'll tell you what, to me, that is tough, because when you look at South Carolina, we didn't think they were going to win 7 games, did we? The win bet on South Carolina over and under was 3.5. And plus, Shane Beamer had all that mayonnaise poured on his head and down his back for winning the bowl.
And crushed in the head with the mayonnaise container, too. Yeah.
And I think you got to look at Mark Stoops again. And he just had a big salary increase to click in. So for our folks
you've named everyone but Heupel, so go ahead.
Heupel, I'm gonna have him third.
Okay.
I really am. And I think Stoops, to me, is the coach that did the most. And he's the only one that won a New Year's Day bowl game out of that group. And it's really close with Shane Beamer as a big underdog beating North Carolina that soundly.
Okay. My number one, I would go Pittman. 9-4, beat Penn State. I did not see that coming. And pick for 6-1, I would go Pittman as the top most with least this year. Who's just your number one?
I would have gone Kiffin. 10 wins, going to the Sugar Bowl in the West. Really impressive.
Genius.
Yeah.
Yeah, and because he is a genius, and you've said it many times, that's why I'm going. No, I would go Kiffin, too. He won 10. It's the first time they've ever won 10 games in the regular season, and so I would go Kiffin.
All right, very good. When we come back, we're going to play a little read and react. I'll show a tweet, a stat, even a photo. These guys see it, they react to it. It's a way to cover a lot of different stories. That's next on the Sports Source. Come on back.
Nevermore to roam. the new year.